What's up guys, in this video I'll show how to create a custom part for Autodesk Eagle. It's a three-step process. First create package, then create symbol, and finally create device. When you put all these pieces together, you will get a tree structure that shows off how libraries in Autodesk Eagle are organized. The component that we'll be creating is an OPAM 741. So let's start with step 1. In Autodesk Eagle, go to File, New, and Library. You can see here we have device, package, symbol, 3D package, but in this video we'll be creating only device, symbol and package. So let's add a package. I'll name it as LIB1. Okay, create. So this is the LM741 datasheet where we have to look at the dimensions. As you can see here, all linear dimensions are in inches or it is in millimeters. Change our grid size in mm. Here the dimensions are maximum valued by minimum value. I am going to choose the maximum value, but it is preferable to choose average of these two values. Now as you can see, the height of IC is 6.60 mm and width is 10.16 mm. So we have to create a rectangle with this dimension. So these are the coordinates that we are going to plot in Eagle to make this rectangular box. So now we will create a rectangular box by just putting the coordinates. The pin to pin distance is 8.26 mm and the height of IC is 6.6 mm, so the resulting difference is 1.66 mm. If we divide this value by 2, the result is 0.83. This 0.83 mm is the distance between pad center and the rectangular box that is drawn. As you can see, the distance between two pins is 2.54 mm. So the distance between first and last pin would be 7.62 mm and the width of the IC is around 10.16 mm. So the resulting difference is 2.54 mm. If we divide this value by 2, we get a result as 1.27. So this much of space we have to leave before placing our first pad. Now we will place our first pad according to this calculated value. Accordingly, decide the coordinates value. You can add a little bit of extra things. Now I am renaming the pads according to pin number. And I'm adding here a text as LM741. Now we are done with step 1. And step 2 is creating symbol. Select symbol and create new symbol. As it is a 8-pin IC, I'll be adding total 8 pins. Now draw the outline using line. Now I am renaming the pins according to data sheet. Let me add a text LM741. So now we are done with symbol as well. It's time to move to third step, and that's creating a device. Select device, name it as LIB1, create it. Now add LIB1 symbol in it and select new. Write the variant name. And select OK. Now it's time to connect symbol and package. Make sure you map each and every pin properly. After connecting all the pins, click OK. Now finally we have created package, symbol and a device. So it's time to save it as a library. Save this file in Eagle's library folder and choose the extension as .lbr if it is not automatically selected. Let's see, is the library added to component list automatically? It's not added. So let's add it manually. Go to library, open library manager and browse your saved file, that is lib1.lbr, and now it's getting added. Now we have successfully added it in our component list. Now we can find it. So here it is, LB1, and now you can add it to your schematic and use in your project. So this is how you can create a custom library. Hope you guys liked it. If you did, don't forget to like and subscribe. And thanks for watching.